All right, everyone. So I'm going to break down my trades from today, a slow day. And this was a little bit of a tough day because Friday was a red day for me. Yesterday was a red day for me. Although, thankfully, the losses were small. If you remember my red days from March, I had back-to-back big red days. My red day on Friday was $650. My red day on Monday was $70. So not a big deal. But today, I knew that I would be kind of feeling this urge to, you know, hit a nice winner after a couple of, a couple of red days. It's just kind of like, all right, I want to get back in the groove, have a nice trade. And so I want to remind myself to take it slow. And I said, look, the reason you had two red days was because the market has been slow. You know, this last week, we had some good moves and then it kind of got a little cold. So don't try to swing big, take it slow. Anyway, so I sat down a little after 7 a.m. And at that time, Pali, P-A-L-I, hadn't come up yet. We had WISA, WISA, which popped up at like 4 a.m. and then dropped back down. It's grinding now, but at 7 a.m. there was nothing to trade. PRSO, this one started moving up a little bit earlier. Choppy, nothing really to trade there either. So we had nothing. And I was like, oh man, this is not looking good. Is this going to be a no trade day? That's not really what I'm looking for. I'd like to have a solid green day, but at the same time, you know, I gotta face facts. So we came up to 8 a.m., top of the hour. I'm like, breaking news. There was nothing at the top of the hour. So then we come to 8:30, bottom of the hour, and that's when Pally came out with news. Unfortunately, Pally didn't end up being that easy to trade. It actually halted down at the open and is going lower now. I hit a peak of $2,000 of profit, and I'm only up $880 on it. It wasn't clean. It was super choppy. It was thickly traded. You know, there was news on it, but it wasn't clean. So if we go back to the very beginning of the move on this, it first hit my scans right at 8:30, and at that time I saw that there was breaking news. So step one is finding a stock moving. I found it on my scanners. So scanners right here, high day momentum scanner showed me that Pally was moving. Step two, what's the catalyst? Saw that there was news. Step three, check the daily chart. I checked the daily chart, had no issue with the daily chart, saw it was a somewhat recent reverse split. I was like, okay, you know, let's give it a shot. Intraday chart, well, this is where we started to have a problem. It popped up to a high of 580 right here. And then drops down to 475. That's a 1-point swing in like 30 seconds. These are 10-second candles. So I was like, all right, this is not great. That's not what I wanted to see. And then pops up to 6. It pulls back. And I bought this dip here at 580. And I kind of held my breath. I was like, uh-oh, this might have been a mistake. But I didn't take 10,000 shares. I didn't even take 5,000 shares. I bought 1,500 shares. It pops up to 630. I locked up $300 of profit. Okay, good. It pulls back. I bought the dip again. Again, 1,500 shares. It comes back up through 630, goes to 650, 675. I add as it squeezes up to 7, and it goes all the way to 780. And in that move right there, I locked up. That was when I hit my peak profit of $2,000 right there. I actually could have walked away right there at 8:33 a.m., and I'd be better off than I am right now. But you never know that. And so anyways, I kept trading it. Sells off, comes back up. Double tops here at 780. But on this drop here, it dropped all the way back down to 681. A dollar a share. Again, big range. The liquidity wasn't great on it. I ended up getting back in right here with my biggest position of the day, 4,500 shares. I punched it. I thought this thing was going to rip through 780. It dropped. I stopped out with a $1,200 loss, or no, it was not that bad. Maybe it was $800 or so. Anyways, I took a loss on it. It goes sideways. It dips down here, and then it rips through 780 and goes up to 8. Part of me wanted to buy it right here, but there were so many sellers at 8. I was like, man, this thing is heavy. It breaks 8. It goes up to 850. I'm like, golly, all right, missed it. Darn it. It pulls back right here. I take this trade, but make basically nothing on it. It pulls back again. It's really not easy to trade through this area. It's just choppy. And then as it breaks through 850, I did get a trade right here. Made a little bit of profit. And then all of a sudden here it dumps, drops 60 cents a share, goes sideways for a while. I tried to take a trade at the open. I had a couple. So I had it halted down and I tried to buy the resumption. It goes lower. I tried to buy the resumption one more time, the dip one more time. It goes lower. Now it's curling off the low, but anyways, I just gave up on it. So, and then in the meantime, I got one trade on BTTR for $200. So sitting at $1,000 of profit on the day, I was able to break my cushion of $1,000 when I got myself up to $2,000, but I never felt comfortable increasing risk. I was like, I'm not going to size up on this. You know, I just don't feel like it's worth it. When we look at the spreads on this, you can see that, you know, it's okay right now because it's gotten a little cheaper. But when it was up around 8.59, 9.50, we were seeing bigger spreads. It was choppy. We were seeing big sellers stacked on the offer. So it feels like there's just been a lot of selling today. And this was really the only stock that I felt like was in play. So, you know, anyways, I tried. I did the best I could on it, but it was another relatively slow day. Yeah, BTTR coming back up. But look at this move. This thing went all the way to 9 and then dropped all the way back down to a low here of 585. That's gross. This is frustrating. I mean, and the thing is, these stocks have news too. You know, I'm trying to trade catalysts. I'm trying to trade stocks that have news. And even then, right now, it feels a little cold. So anyway, BTTR on this one, if we go back here, it started to pop up, and again, I bought a really small size position, just a starter, and that was, where was that? I took two trades on it. I'm pretty sure it was right in here. It was at 8.25, and it went up here to a high of 9, made some money, and then it sells off. I tried to buy the dip here. And then it just ended up rolling over and gave back most of what I'd made on it. So, you know, that was that. Overall market is pulling back a little bit. S&P 500 these last couple days. So this has broken out of the channel that we had to the upside. So we're getting a little bit of a pullback, a little profit taking, which is fine. We were due to have that anyways. So logical support, obviously, is at the 200 moving average. I'm not sure if we're going to pull back that much, but, you know, we might pull back a little bit. Anyways, market has been on a real tear here since November, so we were due for some retracement. Nothing too concerning there. But I think, and I don't think that's really particularly why these last couple days have been choppy. I mean, we've had periods where the market's been down and small caps have still been hot. I think the issue right now is just that we haven't had anything that's been really exciting in these last couple of days. You know, we've had a couple moves, 7,500%, which is great. Pally went up over 100%. You know, WISA was up about 100%. So we've had some small moves, but we haven't had a like 500% move, I feel like, in a couple weeks. So, you know, once we get back into seeing those kinds of moves, that brings some traders off the bench. Because I think right now what ends up happening is traders are just like, I don't know. Like, it feels a little choppy out there. Is it really worth getting chopped up and beaten up? Maybe I should just wait till it gets easier. And, you know, it's easier for some traders to do that than others. When I got started, I didn't have the privilege of being able to say, oh, I could just take a week off of trading and do something else. Trading was the only thing I was doing to make money and pay the bills. So I showed up every single day. I still show up every single day. This is the way I trained myself to think about trading, that I have to try to produce consistent income every single day. So unlike some of the traders out there who can kind of, you know, throw some Hail Mary passes, take some lotto ticket type of trades, I don't do that because I feel mentally like I can't afford the risk. I just stay focused on base hits, getting green, locking it up. Now, occasionally, I'll fall into a cycle where I start getting a little FOMO, I'll see other people having big gains. I try to start swinging for them. And usually when that happens, I'll end up taking some big losses. And then that reminds me to get back in line, get back in the trenches where I belong. And so that's where I'm at. Right now I'm being pretty disciplined about, you know, staying moderate with share size, just trying to, you know, find a couple of good trades each day and really just take like one trade at a time. You know, I'm not trying to be, you know, taking 5, 10, 15 trades at once. I'm just trying to be really disciplined. So that's where it's at. Discipline is key. And anyways, I hope those of you guys who have tuned in had a great day. Hopefully you saw some nice opportunities as well. And I'll be back at it, of course, first thing tomorrow morning, live streaming for our Warrior Pro members. And I'll upload my recap for you guys on YouTube tomorrow afternoon. So by the way, I'll remind you, trading is risky. My results aren't typical, so manage your risk, take it slow. And if you haven't already, hit the thumbs up or subscribe to the channel. I hope you do that. And I'll see you for the next episode real soon.